for it right here. Hey, Stomp. Hey, what's up, y'all? Happy Sunday. I haven't seen y'all in 2 weeks now. I took the 1 week off, and then right after that was Christmas, so I just did a Christmas video. Hoping you had a good holiday. Now we are back. It is the new year. It is 2023. I hope you guys have a wonderful 2023. I hope you had a wonderful 2022, and if you didn't, that just means this year has to get better, just like the next year got to get better, and so on and so forth as we keep it going. I missed you guys, man. 2 weeks off. Felt weird not doing this for 2 weeks, but no, I needed that break, and then it was weirdly the holiday, so we back. We are refreshed. We are ready to go. If you missed my Happy New Year video from last night, basically, all I was saying, at some point, this whole show is going to change. I don't know which day yet, but I will keep you guys posted on the community tabs right here on my channel. But basically, how I dropped the 3 videos on Sundays, I want it to be more of an actual show format. So I gave the example of like Matt Walsh, how he does his show on Daily Wire. I want something more structured like that. So it could, you know, it could be better. You guys get that one good video for the day, and then the rest of the day is about the Lord and being with your family and reading your Bibles. I feel like that would be way better and more structured, and it makes way more sense. But until then, we're still going to do it how we usually do. So, first video of the day is from Frontline TV, and it is titled, Father Vincent Lampert, The Greatest Trick of the Devil. Ooh. Let's see what he has to say. It's pretty short, but doesn't mean you're not going to learn something. But let's go ahead and get into it.
You know, it's funny, because you talk to people, a lot of people don't believe the devil exists. Man, in his hubris, thinks that somehow they're going to skate through this life, you know, without a demonic influence in their life. I mean, I got news to all of our listeners, and I'm sure Father would echo the same thing. The devil is smarter than us all, mm-hmm. and he's stronger than us all, and mm-hmm. I cling to Christ because of that. He gets this much space in your life, and he opens it up before you know it. And before you know it, you're on a road. I mean, I see that in social media, Father. I'll be honest with you. I have to even watch it in myself. Even good things that we all are trying to do, the devil knows our weaknesses and he exploits them. Mm-hmm. Could you tell our audience where and how does the devil operate in the world, to give us a little idea of how he's kind of maneuvering in people's lives? And what does scripture have to say about it?
The church recognizes the extraordinary activity of the devil, and also the ordinary activity of the devil. So the ordinary activity of the devil is what you've been talking about, how the devil in our daily living will try to trip us up. And oftentimes he moves very discreetly. You know, he doesn't really want to be in the limelight. You know, it's the famous French poet, Charles Baudelaire, that said that the devil's cleverest ruse is to convince us that he doesn't exist. And I think a lot of people today kind of fall in line with that sentiment, and if you will, don't realize that perhaps the devil is at work in their lives trying to unravel them and bring about a lot of chaos and destruction. The church does also recognize the extraordinary activity of the devil, and that would be things like demonic infestation, the presence of the devil or a demon in a location or associated with an object. There can be demonic vexation, which are physical attacks, demonic obsession, mental attacks, and then demonic possession, whereby the devil or some other demon would take control of a person's body, treating that body as if it were its own.
Yeah, the devil is definitely real. And it's funny, a lot of people who don't believe, so their whole takeaway, because I used to fall into this category, would be like, if bad things happen, it's just kind of like, oh, it's just, you know, that's life, bad things happen. When the reality of that is that spiritual warfare is real. Like, there's a whole reason that one of you guys actually said this to me in a comment section. I'm trying to make sure I get the wording right. But you have stated that you're not supposed to say a lot of things out loud because demons can latch onto that very easily. So one of you told me that your wife, if she's going through certain things, she'd rather keep it in here than speak it out loud, because she doesn't want that negativity to get a hold on to bring like these demons into your space and mess with your life. Because like I said, spiritual warfare is very real. So earlier in the year, when I was not religious, I was battling a lot of depression and anxiety. And during that time, I've said this in other videos, and I think I'd said this in a video too on one of our Sundays. During that time, a demon was messing with me, and it was to the point where like I was having trouble sleeping. It was bad. It was really bad. This went from like once a week to every other day to almost like every day. It was just constant, right? All of that went away once I started having scripture playing in my house daily, me reading the Bible, me studying Christianity. Majority of that stopped. Now, weird things still happen from time to time, and I have my own stories, especially from around the holiday that week I took off. I might tell y'all that story at some point, and like something happened around Halloween as well, but most of that stopped completely, right? There's a lot of power to the word and what we read every day and believing in Jesus and saying his name, God's name, right? Speaking all of this out aloud, playing it through our speakers. There's a reason certain things stop when you do that. Now, trying to get somebody who doesn't believe to believe in that is kind of hard, right? They would have to experience some things for themselves where it just kind of like flips, because that's what ended up happening with me. But it's very real, and his greatest trick is to make you think that, you know, he's not doing anything at all, when in reality, he is doing the most. Because as we all know, reading our book, the devil, he doesn't want to go down alone. He's trying to take as many souls with him as possible. That's his main goal at the end of the day. So if you somehow stumbled across this video, you know, you making the right decision to follow the right path, so you don't end up going where you're not supposed to go, right? With that being said, let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. As you know, I'll be back at 3 p.m. for the second video of the day, and I hope to see you there. So until next time, until 3 o'clock, you already know who it is. It's Sang.